time once again to bring those hands together. Everybody making some noise. Round of applause. Haddonfield's homeboy Jamie Myers and the killer king of Crystal Lake, Zero Voorhees, bringing the freshest kills in horror news. You know them, you love them. Get that VIP treatment and stay tuned for another episode of Horror from the Grave. Don't forget to tip those waitresses, fellas.
Began the dying centuries ago. Leave the tender blade alone. Let the pain liberate the fallen flow. All the times awaited, all the times away. What is suffering, suffering? Pain and death is waiting. It all gone. You don't need to attempt disformation when you're purified, purified. In the darkness you bleed. See, I am your evil. You don't feel me, cause you're in denial. In denial. Within the power of life.
Greetings from the grave. Haddonfield's homeboy, Jamie Myers, also known as the Michigan Mauler.
Alright. Killer King of Crystal Lake, Zero Voorhees, also known as the Jacksonville Jacker. We gotta plan these things. Because Jacksonville Jumper? Jacksonville...
No, it sounds like you're board jumping or something.
Jacksonville... Welcome to Horror from the Grave on Psychopath TV. The Jacksonville Jalopy. I don't know. I got nothing, man. You got all this cool shit, man. Hatter Splatter, Michigan Mauler, the Florida Flounder. Florida Fallopian Tube Rider. Welcome to another episode of Horror from the Grave out there. How's everyone doing? Super, super. So we got very little news, but we want to take... a moment to remind you, February 1st, Hatchet 2. And also, this killer has got a little backstory of where the legend of Hatchet was born.
Yes, you do.
And how it was born. So check this out. A little trivia. You guys can play on your friends, do a drinking game or whatnot. The concept of Hatchet was born when Adam Green was 8 years old. So for any Miguel fucksticks out there who are saying that Hatchet is a ripoff of Mad Men or The Burning, I want you to take your dick, stick it in a blender, and hit frappe, you ballless piece of shit. Because it is not. When Adam Green was 8 years old, he went to camp, like many kids mm-hmm. of the day, mm-hmm. and the counselor said, don't go in that cabin over there. It was like the last cabin out on the, you know, on the border there. If you will, the edge of the perimeter. Said, don't go in that cabin or Hatchet Face will get you. And turns out that was the counselor's party shack, if you will, the love shack.
And they just didn't want to get cockblocked by some 8-year-old.
Pretty much. I had a nightmare. He's like, tip in. You're about to have another one because you're about to get mushroom stamped, little green boy. So all the kids were freaked out. They were like, we should go check it out, you know. Let's see if Hatchet Face will show up. Adam Green, on the fly, came up with the story of Hatchet Face and made the kids cry so bad that the counselors had to call Adam Green's parents. Damn. For scaring all the other kids.
That's bad.
That's awesome. That's, I like that it. Right there is the moment a star is born.
Yeah.
So there you go. That is the origin of Hatchet. Now, also in Hatchet news, there is preparations. Preparations A through G were a failure. So preparation H for Hatchet 3. That's right. Hatchet 3 on the way. In the works.
In the works.
In the discussion phase. Yes. In the planning phase, mm-hmm. if you will. So there will be a Hatchet 3.
And Adam Green also has a new movie or something. I don't
new
know.
Project.
Yeah, some new project called Killer Pizza.
That origin probably came from when Adam was 12 years old at a Chuck E. Cheese. And that's probably where that's coming from. He was like, you know, when I was 8 and came up with that whole hatchet thing, and that's a hit.
We're 12. We're Ninja Turtles.
Yeah, we're 12. Oh, no. Ninja Turtles with killer pizzas. Let's do that.
Let's do it.
So there you go. So any critics out there, my balls, your mouth, rinse gently.
In other news, Wes Craven is taking the cast back out to film additional scenes for Scream 4.
That's right.
So I need a little more filler for all that killer.
There you go. So there's going to be some new additional scenes. We don't know what, but they'll be in there. And that's pretty much all the news.
No, really. There's a couple little more pieces.
Don't forget to check out the Laid to Rest trailer, too.
Yeah, the Laid to Rest 2 trailer.
It hooked me right away.
Or bloody disgusting.
Yeah, it hooked me right away because it starts off with a tattoo going. And I was like,
oh. Yep. I mean, I'm getting...
And you know what was cool about it? Is it wasn't like a lot of movies do where they have the tattoo machine and it's not even hooked up with the clip cord or whatever. Or even if it's running, there's no needle, you know, or something. Like if you watch The Crow, City of Angels, and she's all tattooing, I'm like, where's the needle bar?
Yeah.
You know? This is real, dude. You could see the needle coming out and the ink and everything. It looks,
and the stencil on.
Yeah, and the stencil's on there and everything. I think the dude really got inked for that part.
And for you people that haven't seen it, Chrome Skull gets a tattoo of himself on his chest. He gets a Chrome Skull chest piece.
Inspired me to get a tattoo of myself hugging Danielle Harris in a red string bikini with knee-high black boots. So look forward to that tattoo.
Also, in a bit of shit news.
Yeah.
And for the people who think that we are hypocritical because we bash on remakes but we like Rob Zombie's H2, there's another remake just for you, buddy. Evil Dead is going to get remade, so...
I thought we could escape it, but,
nope. Not happening.
Nope. And let us clarify that once again. First of all, you jack-offosaurus, you come in midstream and say, oh, you guys just crap on all the other remakes except for Halloween and Rob Zombie. We've given props to other remakes. We've given props to even Platinum Dunes for The Hitcher.
Mm-hmm.
We've given props for Texas Chainsaw Massacre, but that's it. It's a short list, I hate to tell you, but still.
And last time I checked, Rob Zombie's H2 isn't a remake.
No. No.
Because even the hospital scene is nothing like the hospital scene in the original. Yeah. For one, it's only like 5 minutes long.
Right, yeah.
Two, he goes completely fucking psychotic.
Yeah, he wasn't, like, in Halloween 2, the original, he's, like, real stealthy with the scalpel, lot of silent kills. I think the loudest kill was on the security guard with the freaking hammer.
Mm-hmm.
That was the loudest one.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know what? Don't come back, Bill Hader, Gator Tater, Masturbator. Get the fuck on. Don't let the door hit you where the good Lord split you, biatch. I can't stand that kind of shit. I mean, if you've watched us for the past 3 years, then you would know not to have said that, but you haven't, so.
Yeah, there's some dude I never even knew.
I just can't, you know. I don't know. That's about all I can say about that. I'm going to get all worked up and shit, but, yeah. So, we're just going to go ahead, jump right in to killer questions.
For that ass.
Oh, wait, there was one other little bit of itty-bitty titty news. Anthony Hopkins is going to play Alfred Hitchcock. This is the dumbest shit I've ever read in my life. I actually felt my IQ drop because I see a new trend coming. Anthony Hopkins is going to play Alfred Hitchcock in Alfred Hitchcock, The Making of Psycho. Here's the trend I see coming. Seth Rogen stars as John Carpenter in The Making of Halloween.
Yeah.
Dylan McDermott stars as Wes Craven and The Making of Nightmare on Elm Street. Daniel McFiddlefuck stars as Sean Cunningham in The Making of Friday the 13th. So this is just dumb.
Weird shit.
It's another proof that, well, we really don't have to think of anything. All we got to do is read the memoirs of Alfred Hitchcock on how he made Psycho and then just, you know, make that.
Make a movie of it.
So basically you're going to go pay $10.50 to see Anthony Hopkins in a fat suit playing Alfred Hitchcock in The Making of Psycho, which, unless you've been under a fucking boulder for 18 years, there's already documentaries on how Alfred Hitchcock made Psycho.
Mm-hmm.
So now they're remaking documentaries.
Yeah.
Brilliant, Hollywood. Fucking brilliant. Killer questions. We're going to start it off with the Anime Angel 20-06. Here we go.
Jamie, have you read my Omen of Teaberry story yet? No, I haven't. I've been super fucking busy, but I promise I'm going to read it.
He's going to check it out.
Someday, soon. I have jury duty and all this shit. And jury duty just ended on
Wednesday. Working 6 days a week.
Yeah, and one of those shifts is a double on the worst day to do a double. There's just a lot of shit going on, but I promise you I'm going to read it. Actually, I'll read it Saturday when I get out of work.
There you go.
I'll do it Saturday. So ask me that question again in another week.
I read on one of the Clive Barker websites. How many does he have? That Clive Barker was in talks with Disney and 20th Century Fox to get his novel series, The Aberrant, and his novel, Thief of Always, to become big screen adaptations. They were said to hit theaters in 2012 or 13. Do you think the fans could encourage him to bring these books of his to the big screen and direct so he can return and bring some originality back to the horror film world? Well, if he's in talks with Disney, I'm pretty sure the horror shit is dead.
Yeah.
They're not going to go for it. They never have. They never will. Unless it's like one of those branch off Miramax type things, but I don't know. I think Clive Barker, I mean, if those books, Thief of Always, that doesn't even sound like horror.
Mm-mm.
But I don't know. You're the expert on that. I don't read anything that doesn't have a sniper rifle in it.
And I don't follow Clive Barker as much anymore.
He's kind of fell off the map. And when you do that in the entertainment world, if you fall off too long, you're not going to be welcomed back as, you know.
No, and the fact
that he's degree letting, you left off.
He's letting Hellraiser get taken to shit.
Yeah, I mean, with all the evidence of what they've been doing to remakes and stuff.
And I still like the man, don't get me wrong. I just don't follow him as close as I used to.
Yeah.
It has nothing to do with, oh, I hate Clive Barker, because I know that's what some of you may think or say, but we don't hate Clive Barker.
No, we don't.
We just don't follow him as much.
Right. We're keeping up with the news.
So just like John Carpenter, you don't follow him after forever because he didn't do shit, but now he's back in the fucking game. We got fucking 25 movies coming out here pretty soon. So I'm like, oh shit, let's see what old Johnny's been up to lately.
Yeah.
You know, so that's kind of how it goes.
Yeah. If Bobby Flay had an Iron Chef match against any of the horror movie slashers, who do you think would he challenge and why?
Note that the secret ingredient they have to use for their dishes is deer meat.
Deer meat's good, man. I mean, deer jerky is.
Mm-hmm.
Never jerked a deer, but deer jerky.
I'm
going to say he goes up against Freddy, and they make deer meat a la tartare. The stupid Frightmare Fright Night remake is coming out August 19th, 2011, according to comingsoon.net. I go to a different comingsoon.com. Spelled a little different. Anyway.
Knowing that I'm not going to see it because the original is better.
Amen.
I even boycotted the Nightmare remake because it looks stupid.
And it was.
And they are making
another Spy Kids.
When is this redneck craziness going to stop for real?
It's not.
If they try to remake the Ernest films, we need to go take them by their underwear and throw them into the street and shoot them or feed them to the piranhas.
I take feeding the piranhas.
I hope all the killers are ready to boycott the remakes and not go see them because I'm not standing for it. Are you guys ready to boycott the remakes? And do you think the killers are? At least DreamWorks, Disney, and some movie people are going original in their films. Let's just hope everyone else will too.
Well, we already started. I already did. I know I started boycotting them, so I'm not going to go see the Fright Night remake. I'm not even going to go see it to be like, ooh, that's on this road, and ooh, that's on this road, because it was made here in Albuquerque. But no, I don't give a fuck if McLovin's in it or not. I'm not going to see it. I'm not. What is your favorite Dairy Queen Blizzard flavor? Kit I like Kat. Chocolate Extreme. Ooh, Kit Kat's a good one.
I like the
Kit Kat. I'm all about the Reese's Peanut Butter, man.
I like that one, too. Oh, yeah. That's like tied for Kit Kat with me. Some days I feel a little Reese. Some days I feel a little Kit Kat.
There you go. Some this days depends. Your peanut butter, some days your wafer.
Because you never know. You may walk up to that motherfucker, Reese's Reese, and you get there, I don't want a Kit Kat Blizzard.
You know that's happened to me sometimes.
It's happened to me too.
You look up at the menu and you're like, oh,
because the right. Dairy Queen line is long.
It does give you a lot of time to second guess yourself.
To ponder everything you're...
That's all the questions. Thanks a lot, Amber, a.k.a. Anime Angel OG13. Mistress of the dock. Of the dock.
Okay, now we gotta go forward because...
We gotta fast forward now because that was on a previous page. By the way, did you guys see the trailer for The Victim with Danielle Harris in a red string bikini and knee-high black boots?
All right. One of our boys, The Killer Miller, 666.
666.
Just got a YouTube page. He's been following us for a long time.
Like, oh, right on.
I've been talking to this kid for everybody.
Finally. Yeah, Noah. That sounds familiar.
Yeah,
Noah. I remember you mentioning him. Yeah.
He's the one who painted all the horror characters on his walls and shit.
Yes.
Remember?
Okay.
From a long time ago?
Yep.
He fucked. And I had to harass him into getting to Facebook. He was still talking to me on MySpace. I'm like, you know, you're the only person that talks to me on here.
You are walking a graveyard. Bro.
You and Russell Simmons are the only motherfuckers that talk to me on here.
That's it. So, yeah. He's got his own channel there. Ooh, it's time for some killer trivia for that ass. All right, do we have time to do this, right?
No. Well, let's
let's do the Bloody Machete 69 killer questions, and then we'll go on the next episode and do the trivia for that ass.
He's got a bunch of questions too.
Holy shit!
Yeah. See.
What about the other one? The one above it. That one. Still a lot of them.
More than
Bloody
that
Machete 69, my lord, man. You are good to go. Let's see.
Inmate has a little quick
inmate one. Inmate Killer has a quick one. All right, here we go. We wasted more time looking for questions than we could. All right, here we go. Inmate Killer. Zero, Jamie, you two wake up one day, and God said that he wants you two to go on a killing spree and have the highest body count of child molestators. Rape, murders, child murders. And you would not go to jail or prison. And he wants them to die the way you want. And have to be 150 times worse than their victims. Alright. Alright. Then we do it. We sharpen up the butcher knife. We sharpen up the machetes. We grind the axe. We load the sniper rifles. We refill the propane tank on the flamethrower. And we go and do this.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Totally.
Go Boondock Saints on these asses.
There's only a couple things in this life that me and this guy feel are unforgivable.
Mm-hmm.
You know, someone breaks in your house, you fucking shoot them, you kill them. They shouldn't have broken your fucking house. That's a reason to
wrong
fucking
place,
do some
wrong
shit.
Time, yeah.
But molesting kids, raping anyone, man or woman, because there's sick fucks out there that rape men too, those are unforgivable crimes to us.
The way I see it, they should be taken up in a C-130 about 40,000 feet and boot.
Yeah.
With no parachute.
No, not at
all. Not even a paper bag to use as a parachute. Nothing. Just kick them out. Naked.
Yeah, I...
As a matter of fact, we got a case here. And this hit me so much that I got the newspaper and I'm actually going to hang the picture in my dojo to remember this little kid as much as possible. Where these two fuckheads beat to death a 3-year-old little boy.
Oh yeah, I was on the paper today.
My son Michael is going on 3 in March.
Mm-hmm.
And if anyone hurt him, it would be the worst torture that those fuckers would ever experience in their life.
Yeah.
So the kid stuff definitely hits home to me. Anyone mess with my Jason and Michael, a horror movie couldn't even touch what I would do.
Exactly.
It'd be a shadow of a shadow.
Yeah.
So, and we read the PS part, man, and really heartfelt, me and Jamie. That really sucks.
Yeah.
And you know what? Turn that rage into something positive. You know, you can do volunteer work. You know, you can share your story with other people. And, you know, just turn it into... Because it's all about power for these sick fuckheads. They think they get power from it, and they think it makes them something that they're not.
Mm-hmm.
Don't give it to them.
Mm-hmm.
Don't give it to them.
Yep.
Destroy them in your mind, and then take that experience and give it to people who can benefit from your experience. That's what I say on.